This is the third generation Porsche Cayenne, which you have probably surmised already given that it looks quite similar to the second generation car, which wasn't a million miles away from the original. However, with 770,000 Cayennes sold since 2002, Porsche is understandably wary of meddling with a style that works so well. Gradual evolution hasn't done the 911 any harm now, has it? Underneath, the changes are much more drastic, with this Cayenne based on the MLB platform that also sees service in the Bentley Bentayga, plus a host of driver-focused chassis technology. Rear wheel steering is an option, along with the electromechanical anti-roll system first seen on the Audi SQ7, and updated air suspension too. Add to those new engines and a thoroughly overhauled interior, and it's plain that there's far more to this Cayenne than first meets the eye. Fairly tremendous actually, at a great many things. Buyers will make their own minds up about the looks, although it's probably fair to say that those never previously sold on the largest Porsche SUV won't find much to change their mind here. There can be no complaints about this new Cayenne's interior, however. Both the Cayenne and the Macan have been recognized for their dynamic acumen, though it's seldom, if ever, that they're complimented for a sense of luxury. That changes here, this new Cayenne taking up where the Panamera left off, with a stunning interior comprised of sumptuous materials, seamlessly integrated technology and considerable style. It's difficult to imagine wanting more from an interior in a car costing comfortably less than £100,000, impeccably appointed, intuitive and as connected as any buyer will currently need. The Cayenne's cabin is a triumph. Oh yes, and there's now an extra 100 liters of boot space. The Cayenne S uses a 2.9-liter twin-turbo V6 and an 8-speed automatic gearbox, a broadly similar powertrain to that in the Audi RS5, albeit with marginally less power at 434 bhp. Crucially, this powertrain feels a better fit here than in the sports coupe. The generous spread of torque -405 lb-ft from 1,800–5,500 revolutions per minute, arguably more befitting of a 2020 kilograms SUV, yes, not much weight has been lost, than an M3 chasing two-door. It lends the Cayenne S a fair turn of speed, certainly enough to make the 164 miles per hour claim top speed seem eminently achievable on our brief drive. With minimal lag and a swift-acting automatic gearbox, the turbocharged V6 will provide all the performance most buyers will require. While dynamic praise of this latest Cayenne is wholly justified, it must be qualified, as is often the case nowadays, by how options are chosen. For instance, our test Cayenne S featured carbon ceramic brakes, nice to have though hardly vital for many SUV buyers. In addition to adaptive air suspension, rear axle steering and 21-in wheels. When you bear in mind that a standard car would use steel springs, half the amount of steered wheels, smaller rims and iron brakes, you can see how it is hard to make a definitive judgment on the standard Cayenne S. As you might expect, however, the test car delivered a stellar dynamic performance, with a lower curb weight than both the Bentley Bentayga and the Audi Q7 with which it shares a platform. The Porsche is a sharper, more direct and more responsive drive. Hackneyed though it may sound, it doesn't corner unlike a large hatch, darting into bends with a neutral cornering attitude. Indeed, while Porsche's claim of this being more like a 911 than ever should be taken with a pinch of salt, it's the Cayenne's rear-driven wheels that feel to be doing most of the work on corner exit.
At low revs, it delivers power smoothly and near silently.